Hey guys, what's up? So, been sitting here working on my outreaches for October and November, and it's just kind of stressing. I just remember what this time of year was like when I was on the streets. The weather changes. I'm noticing that it's getting colder here in Los Angeles, and tonight's leading story, at least on ABC News, ABC 7, is the need for donations for an outreach down on Skid Row. And as many of you know from reading my blog or watching my YouTube channel, I was down on Skid Row for a bit, and it was not, let's just say I don't have any fond memories of Skid Row, nor of downtown Los Angeles, and I don't care how much gentrification takes place down there, there are people down there that are suffering. And they're suffering unnecessarily at the hands of a government that refuses to acknowledge them, and at the hands of people who refuse to help them for one reason or another. There is an outreach tomorrow on Skid Row, and it is to get school supplies to children, back to school supplies, backpacks, shoes, books, anything you need for back to school. I remember as a kid, going and getting all my school supplies and getting all my notebooks and stuff. And as a kid, you never really think about what that stuff actually costs. And I remember once I got into like junior high school, being the bookworm that I was, I had a notebook for every subject, and I was a true nerd. I didn't just have the little regular skinny notebooks. I had the big 3-ring notebooks, and I had to have all the dividers and all this stuff, and that carried on into high school and then into college. It's just interesting to me that the news media and our city leaders, our elected state and national leaders, you don't hear much about homelessness and poverty in this nation, the United States of America, until right around the holidays. It's almost like it's non-existent until the holidays, and people get in there, let's go help the poor and needy at Thanksgiving, let's go serve the poor and needy. And my question is, where is all this outpouring of love and support throughout the year? Why is it only that we as Americans only seem to care about each other during the holidays? Why is it that we are so quick to say negative things and kick somebody while they are down instead of just saying, you know what, how can I help? How can I help? It just doesn't make any sense to me. One of the reasons why I do what I do is because it is something that was instilled in me as a kid. It was something that I saw my family do, without excuse, without reservation, without hesitation. And it is something that I've done my whole life. I know a lot of people think, oh, he just started this because he was homeless. No, I've been doing this for a very, very long time. This just didn't start when I became homeless. I will say that it is definitely my passion now. I know that it is my purpose. It is my mission. It is what I'm called to do. I will say that. They were showing on the news that people are lined up around the block to try to get these donations. And there was a person from the Fred Jordan Mission that is saying they may not have the supplies to actually help people because of the economy being the way it is. It was interesting to see one lady say that she was sent to this mission by another mission because the mission she is in doesn't provide things like that, which might be shocking to everybody on the outside, but to me it's not shocking at all. There are a lot of things that the missions and shelters don't provide for one reason or another. I think if we look closely at the pyramid, for lack of a better word, and see these astronomical salaries that are being paid, I think if we flip the pyramid upside down and took those astronomical salaries and used those for programs and actually helping people and paying these so-called executives a little bit less, and some of them could be paid a lot less, we could do more for people. But that's too much like right, as my Nana used to say. So as I sit here and think about the three outreaches that I have coming up in October for Shriners Hospital, and then two in November, one Thanksgiving Day, and then another one the weekend, the Saturday after Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving Day will be for homeless people, and then the Saturday after Thanksgiving will be for people living with HIV and AIDS. And as I sit here and try to make plans for that and try to get ready for that, I know that the bulk of this is going to fall on me. I know if I don't work my ass off in finding the donations, come hell or high water, they just won't come in. If I don't work as hard as I possibly can to come up with the 40 stuffed animals for the outreach to Shriners Hospital, then it won't happen. I know if I don't work as hard as I can to feed as many homeless people Thanksgiving Day as I possibly can, it just won't happen. And I know if I don't work as hard as I possibly can to find clothes, hygiene items, and donations of food to help me feed 40 people who are battling HIV and AIDS down on Skid Row, it won't happen. And I know that for every single time I set out to do an outreach, that ultimately it is my dream, ultimately it is my goal. And I've got so many cheerleaders, but not many workers. I got so many people screaming rah, 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 but not many people willing to actually do some work. I got many people saying, I will do this, but not following through in the end. As I sit here and plan all this out, I'm just saying to myself, you know what, God, remove all the distractions. Remove all the things that will distract me from getting the job done. And just tonight, I mean, just tonight, and as of last week and the week before that, just having people walk out of my life, having people just stop talking to me altogether. And tonight I'm sitting on the couch, and then I'm over here and I'm working, and I'm just saying to myself, I'm a little bothered by people walking out, but I'm also clear that I've said, God, if it's a distraction, please remove it. So that's where I'm at right now. My focus is on my organization. My focus is on my outreach. And my focus is about helping people because I know what it was like to be out there on those streets for 29 months with nothing to eat. I know what it's like to eat out of a trash can. I know what it's like to turn a trick just to have a place to sleep. I know what that's like. So when I say I have no judgments for people, I mean just that. I have no judgments for people. When I say I am helping people, I mean just that. I'm going to help people to the best of my ability. Come hell or high water, I'm gonna do it. Because it was people who offered me the bottle of water. People who stopped and said, hey, let me get you something to eat. And it is what God called me to do. What God has called me to do. And I'm gonna keep on doing it, no matter what. No matter who supports or doesn't support it. So peace and blessings, everybody.